Hi everyone, this is Sridhar at eShikshana. Before going through this video, I suggest you to go through my previous video on telemetry, where I have discussed the different types of telemetry systems. And in this video, we'll discuss the continuation of my previous topic. We have a discussion on modulation and demodulation, frequency modulation, telemetry system, pulse amplitude modulation, telemetry system, pulse code modulation, telemetry system. First, we'll start the discussion with modulation and demodulation. In modulation, we'll discuss the definition of modulation, need for modulation, methods of modulation, digital modulation techniques, demodulation or detection, noise, modems. First, we'll discuss modulation and demodulation. The different types of signals in transmission through atmosphere generally encounters issues in communication systems have frequent spectra that is not suitable for direct transmission. In such case, the frequency spectra of a signal may be translated by modulating high frequency carrier wave with a signal. To transmit and receive data successfully, there are two essential processes. First one is modulation and second one is demodulation. We'll see the definition of modulation first. It is a process of combining the low frequency signal with a very high frequency radio wave called carrier wave. And also we can define the modulation in different ways, or it is a process in electronic circuit. The characteristics of one wave, which is carrier, is modified by the variation in another wave, which is the radio signal. Or also we can define as it is the process of combining audio frequency signal with a radio frequency carrier wave. By considering the figure shown, a AF signal is called modulating wave and the resulting wave produced is called modulated wave. During modulation, some characteristics of a carrier wave is varied in time with the modulating signal, and it is done by combining the two waves, so which can be seen in the diagram. So where the RF carrier signal is fed to a modulator and AF signal is fed to a modulator. Further, the modulated wave is a combination of these two signals. Next, we'll discuss on need for modulation. In electronic communication, the modulation it is necessary for the following reasons. The first reason is that a modulation increases the operating range. It reduces the size of transmitting and receiving antennas. It permits transmission without wire. It is extremely difficult to radiate low frequency signal through Earth atmosphere in the form of electromagnetic energy. So due to these reasons, we can say modulation is required. Next, we'll discuss on methods of modulation. The mathematical expression for a sinusoidal carrier wave is given by the equation where EC is the amplitude, FC is the frequency, and phi is the phase. So the waveform can be varied by any of these factors or parameters. Accordingly, there are three types of sine wave modulations: amplitude modulation, frequency modulation, the third one is pulse or phase modulation. We'll discuss these three one by one. First, we'll discuss on amplitude modulation. The amplitude modulation is defined as the process by which the amplitude of a carrier wave is varied in accordance with the modulating signal is called amplitude modulation. So in this method, the amplitude of a carrier wave is varied. Hence, it is an amplitude modulation. We'll see the process of amplitude modulation by considering the diagram. Referring to the diagram, for the sake of simplicity, we consider the AF message signal has been sinusoidal signal, which is shown in the figure A. The carrier wave by which it is desired to transmit the AF signal is shown in figure B. The third figure C shows the resultant wave, which is called as modulated wave. The function of modulation is to mix the two waves in such a way that the AF signal shown in figure A is transmitted along with the carrier wave B. Considering the sine wave as the AF signal, which has to be transmitted over a distance, by use of these carrier wave signal, the resultant waveform is a modulated wave, where EC minimum is this level and EC maximum is this level. The fluctuations in the amplitude of the carrier wave depend on the signal amplitude and the rate at which these fluctuations take place, depending on the frequency of audio signal. All stations are broadcasting on a standard broadcast band, uses AM modulation, which is 550 to 1550 kilohertz. Percent modulation indicates the degree to which the AF signal modulates the carrier wave. There are two methods of amplitude modulations: amplifier modulation and oscillator modulation. Next, we'll discuss on the limitation of amplitude modulations. The limitations are smaller operating range, and it has a poor efficiency and a poor audio quality and noisy reception. Next, we'll discuss on frequency modulation. This is the process by which the frequency of a carrier wave is varied in accordance with the modulating signal is called as frequency modulation. In this method, the frequency of a carrier wave is varied. We'll discuss the process of frequency modulation by considering the diagram. The wave shown in the figure A is a signal, the figure B is a carrier, and figure C is the resultant frequency of a modulated wave. When a signal frequency FS is modulated with a carrier wave FC, a modulated wave is produced, which is shown in figure C. The following points are to be noted here. The amplitude of a modulated wave is same as that of the carrier wave, and the frequency of a modulated wave varies in accordance with the message signal. The advantage of frequency modulations are better audio quality and high transmission efficiency, which has low noise or noiseless reception. And we have few limitations of frequency modulation, which are smaller area or reception, the wide channel is needed, the equipment used is more complex and costlier. So this is about the frequency modulation. Next, we'll discuss on pulse modulation. It is a technique of modulating the analog signal and converting it into a corresponding values. So in this process, the instantaneous voltage of the analog signal is sampled at regular intervals and transmitted during these sample periods only. In analog modulation, the amplitude or a frequency or phase of a carrier is varied according to the instantaneous voltage of the signal. And in pulse modulation, either amplitude or width or a position of the pulse is varied according to the instantaneous voltage of the signal. The pulse modulation is classified as the two different ways, analog and digital. The analog classification can be represented as PAM, pulse amplitude modulation, and PTM, pulse time modulation. Further, we can categorize as PDM, pulse duration modulation, PWM, pulse width modulation, and PPM, pulse position modulation. And digital modulation can be classified as PCM, pulse code modulation, and delta modulation. So before going through these discussion, we'll discuss on the sampling theorem. The sampling theorem is developed by the Nyquist, and it states as, if the sampling rate is any pulse modulating system exceeds twice the maximum signal frequency, the original signal can be constructed at the receiver with minimum distortion. If FM is the maximum signal frequency, then sampling rate is greater than 2FM. The minimum sampling rate is called as the Nyquist rate. The reciprocal of the sampling rate or a sampling frequency is called sampling time or Nyquist interval. Next, we'll discuss on pulse amplitude modulation. In short, we can call it as PAM, and it can be generated by using AND gate. The PAM can be demodulated by passing through the low pass filter with cutoff frequency is higher than the signal frequency. Generally, FM is used to modulate the pulse so that it can be transmitted. Such a system is called PAM-FM. Next, we'll discuss on pulse width modulation. It is also called pulse duration modulation, PDM, or pulse length modulation, PLM. It can be generated using a monostable multivibrator. It can be demodulated by feeding the PWM signal to an integrating circuit. In PWM, the width of the pulse is changed in accordance with the instantaneous values of modulating signal, with amplitude remaining constant. The most oftenly used integrated circuit is the loudspeaker itself. Next, we'll discuss on pulse position modulation. In short, we can call it as PPM. It can be generated in similar way as the PWM, but the pulse width is kept constant from the starting point of occurrence of the pulse. It can be demodulated by converting into PWM using a flip-flop. In PPM, the position of the pulse or the time of occurrence of the pulses is changed in accordance with the instantaneous magnitude of the modulating signal. So this is about the PPM. Next, we'll discuss on pulse code modulation. In short, we can call it as PCM. In this type, the modulation of a digital equivalent of instantaneous voltage levels of our signals are transmitted in the form of pulses. The total amplitude range which the signal may occupy is divided into the number of standard levels. This process is called quantizing. The level actually is the set of the nearest standard level. The quantization level depends on the number of bits per sample. the PCM encoder functions similar to the analog to digital converter, and PCM decoder functions similar to the digital to analog converter. This is about the pulse code modulation. Next, we'll discuss on digital modulation techniques. In digital communication, the modulation signal consists of a binary data or an M array, encoded version of it. The data is used to modulate a carrier wave, usually a sinusoidal, with a fixed frequency. The input data may be represented in digital computer outputs or PCM waves generated by the digital voice or video signals. The channel may be a telephone channel or microwave radio link or a satellite channel or an optical fiber. In digital communication, the modulation process involves switching or keying the amplitude, frequency or phase of the carrier in accordance with the input data. And there are three basic modulation techniques for the transmission of digital data: amplitude shift keying, frequency shift keying, and phase shift keying. The above techniques can be reviewed as a special cases of amplitude modulation, the frequency modulation and phase modulation respectively. The types of digital modulation techniques are coherent digital modulation technique, coherent binary modulation technique, coherent binary amplitude shift keying or on-off keying, coherent demodulation of binary ASK, binary phase shift keying, and coherent binary frequency shift keying. The second one is non-coherent binary modulation technique, involves non-coherent binary ASK, non-coherent detection of FSK, differential phase shift keying, and quadrature phase shift keying. Next, we'll discuss on demodulation or detection. It is the process of extracting a low frequency modulated signal from the modulated wave is known as demodulation or detection. The modulation of AM wave involves the two operations: rectification of modulated wave and elimination of RF component of the modulated wave. The demodulation of an FM wave involves the three operations. The first one is conversion of the frequency changes produced by modulating signal into corresponding amplitude changes. Second one, rectification of modulating signal. Third one, elimination of RF component of the modulated wave. So this is about the demodulation or detection. Next, we'll discuss on noise. Noise may be defined as an extraneous form of energy trending to interface with the proper and easy reception of reproduction of those signal which is desirable to receive. Next, we'll discuss on noise power. Noise power is a directly proportional to temperature, bandwidth of a system, and independent resistance value. Unit of noise power is watts. Unit of noise power density or watt per hertz. Average thermal noise power is constant as long as the bandwidth is fixed. The thermal noise voltage is proportional to the temperature, bandwidth, and resistance. Next, we'll discuss on noise figure. It is the ratio of signal to noise at the input to the signal to noise at the output. The ideal noise figure is 0 or 1 decibel. noise figure is always greater than 1. The higher noise figure of the amplifier, noisier the amplifier. We can classify the noise as internal noise and external noise. Further, internal noise can be classified as thermal noise, short noise, transient time noise, miscellaneous noise. External noise can be classified as atmospheric noise, extraterrestrial noise, man-made noise. Further, extraterrestrial noise can be classified as solar noise and the cosmic noise. All receivers have the basic components consisting the tubes of transistors. The different types of noise present in these devices are the thermal noises, short noises, and partition noises, etc. In super heterodyne receivers, mixers are made much noisier than the amplifiers. It is because the plate current of the partition noise is greatly increased in the mixers. At shorter wave frequencies, the image frequency rejection is very poor and this introduces noises. The low value of transduction also helps in the increasing the noise. Thus, the effect of noise is maximum in mixers and all the receivers. Next, we'll discuss on modems. The modem is a short form of modulator and demodulator. The modem is a device that converts data from digital computer signal to analog signal that can be sent over a phone line. This is called modulation. The analog signals are then converted back into a digital data by receiving modem. This is called demodulation. The diagram shows a modem interfacing block diagram, which consisting of a modulator and demodulator. The DC pulses from the computer terminals are fed to the interfacing circuits, further passed through the modulator circuits and filters and the output amplifier. So this is the resultant analog signals to the transmission link. Further, the demodulator, the same analog signal from the transmission link is fed to a filters and input amplifier. The demodulator circuits and the interfacing circuits are passed DC pulses through the computer terminals. So everything is being controlled by the control and timing circuit and powered by the single power supply. A modem is fed with the digital information in the form of zeros and ones from the CPU. The modem then analyzes this information and converts into analog signals, then it can be sent over a telephone line. Another modem then receives these signals, convert back them into a digital data and then sends to a receiving CPU. We have a different types of modem, voice grade modems and telephone plus, wideband modems, short haul modems, modem eliminators or line diverters or receivers, frequency shift keying, FSK modems can be categorized into different Bell 103 modem, V21 modem, Bell 202 modem. The phase shift keying FSK modems can be categorized into 201 modem, V26 modem, Bell 212 modem, V22 and so on. And we have a data modems, smart modems, multi-port modems and radio modems. The modem modulation methods are amplitude modulation, frequency shift keying, phase modulation, differential phase shift keying, and multi-level modulation. Next, we'll discuss on frequency modulation telemetry system. The frequency modulation is one of the earliest techniques for mixing or multiplexing data channels in a telemetry system and is still in use. The figure shows the frequency modulation telemetry system where the input signals are sensed by the transducer and further sent to the signal conditioning circuit further pass through a VCO, which is a voltage controlled oscillator, and through a mixer, and then it is transmitted through antenna. The receiving antenna receives those pulses and demodulates them and sends to a data output. The output of each transducer or a signal conditioner modulates the frequency of voltage controlled subcarrier oscillator. Many oscillators, each operating in an dedicated port of a frequency spectrum, are mixed for radio transmission. Each voltage controlled oscillator is assigned with a separate frequency or a frequency spectrum to each signal that can be modulated with interfacing with other signals. At the receiving station, FM modulator is turned to the frequency of each subcarrier. When the measurement value changes at the source, the output voltage of discriminator changes accordingly. So this is how the frequency modulation telemetry system works. Next, we'll discuss on pulse amplitude modulation telemetry system. The primary limitation of FM telemetry system is the capacity of channels offered is less. To have higher capacity of channel within the line bandwidth, the PAM telemetry system is widely used. The PAM telemetry system uses time division multiplexing technique. The diagram shows the basic time division multiplexing system consisting of multiple channels fed through a commutator and then transmitted. Here we have a decommutator receiving the different channel inputs, further sent through a different channel outputs. All channels uses the same frequency band of the allocated frequency spectrum, but not at the same time. The commutator samples the signal in each channel in sequence, and the amplitude of each is an indication of the instantaneous data value at that point. After sampling of all channels, the sequence start over the first channel. Thus, samples from the particular channel are interleveled in the time with samples from all other channels, and the amplitude of each modulated by the input data. Because in time division system, no channel is monitored continuously, the sampling must be rapid enough that the signal amplitude in any channel does not change too much between the sampling intervals, and the information in original signal is preserved. So in a typical telemetry system, the sampling rate is about 5 times higher frequency component in the sampling signal. The decommutator at the receiving end of the system operates exactly as same as the frequency as the commutator at the distributors, the parts of the multiplexed signal to the proper output channels. The time division system is based on the precise timing. It is of the significant importance that the demodulator be synchronized exactly with the commutator. So this is how the PAM telemetry system works. Next, we'll discuss on pulse code modulation telemetry system. The system is named since the measured data is represented in the form of binary weighted codes. This is also make use of time division multiplexing system. However, in the system, the encoder is used after the computer stage. The figure shows the block diagram of PCM telemetry system, which consists of transmitter section and the receiver section. At the transmitter section, we have the different inputs fed through the different channels synchronized by the channel synchronization signal commutator, and encoder encodes the data and transmits, and at the receiver end receives the signal which bit synchronizes and frame synchronizer used to output at the different selected channels. The function of a decoder is to accept the each PM sample and convert it into a binary number and shift the bits of each number serially. The encoder converts zero amplitude pulses to a binary number 0, while full scale pulses into a binary number 1023. Each number is exactly proportional to the instantaneous amplitude of signal at measuring point. The receiver section is synchronized on the serial data system. The bit synchronizer and the frame synchronizer identify each sequence of bits and convert it into a useful output. So this is about the pulse code modulation telemetry system. Next, you can compare the FM, PM and PCM and try to get the differential features of these three systems. This is it in this video. Thank you for watching.